An overarching goal of a regression analysis is to model non-numerical outcomes based on available input features. There are different approaches to regression analysis. One of the most popular approaches is linear regression, in which we model the target variable y as a linear combination of input features x. If there is only one input feature, then the resulting model describes a regression line. If there are more than one input features, then the model describes a regression hyperplane. Here is another example of a linear regression model. In this model, the slope and the intercept of the line is controlled by the regression coefficients a1 and a0, respectively. Fitting a linear regression model means adjusting these regression coefficients to best describe the relationship between x and y. Then how do we find the best regression coefficients? To do so, we find the error between the observed data and the linear regression model at each data point. These errors are referred as residuals. The best model minimizes the residuals for all data points simultaneously. So we find the regression coefficients for our model that minimizes the sum of squared residuals. There is a closed form solution for the optimum regression coefficients, as you can see in the formula. The regression model can be estimated by the linear regression learner node in the KNIME Analytics platform. And the resulting model can be used to predict outcomes by the regression predictor node. The learner node takes a data set at the input port and produces the regression model at the output port. In the configuration window, we specify the target column or the outcome variable as well as the input features. In this example, we use a car dataset, and we are interested in predicting the miles per gallon (mpg) of a car, explained by the numerical feature horsepower (hp). These radio buttons allow us to select the input features manually one by one or in bulk using a wildcard or a regular expression pattern. Two options for handling missing values are available. We can either ignore them or stop processing if there are any missing values. After executing the learner node, we can examine the resulting regression model by right-clicking the output port and selecting View Linear Regression Results View. It shows a list of regression coefficients, their standard error, t-statistic value, and the p-value. By right-clicking the output port of the learner node, and by selecting View Linear Regression Scatter Plot View, you can see the linear regression model overlaid on top of observed data in a scatter plot. The model trained in the learner node can be used in the regression predictor node. As in other machine learning predictor nodes, the input to this node includes the trained model from the learner node, as well as a data set used for prediction. The configuration window is simple and only offers an option to rename the prediction column from the default name. The performance of the model can be summarized by various goodness of fit metrics calculated in the numeric scorer node. In this example, our model had R squared of 0.574. In other words, 57% of all variability was explained by this linear regression model.